Hello students, myself Shadab Sultana, I am your science teacher and you are the student of class 5 now. Hope you all are fit and fine. Students, as we all know that due to corona pandemic, the whole country has locked down itself. Because of it, the country is struggling with schools, teachers and lack of proper education. But to tackle this situation, most of the schools of the country have started the process of online classes. Students, you must take advantage of this opportunity. And here we are to facilitate you, and we too have started taking the online classes. About the process and procedure of online classes, you have been notified on your WhatsApp number. Hence, I welcome you all on joining the online classes. Now, we shall move towards our studies. Students, one important note for you students. Have study materials along with you in each and every class that you attend for. Study materials in the sense pen, pencil, eraser, sharpener and so on. And note all the points that will be taught to you and which will be written on the blackboard. About the correction of those notes and homeworks, we will let you know soon. But till then, keep the notes safe and ready up to date. Alright? Now, before starting any of the lesson, we must know about our subject. Our subject, science. So, students, what is science or how could we define science? Science, in simple terms, can be defined as a systematic study of knowledge. How could we define science? So, science is a systematic study of knowledge. Science is a systematic study of knowledge. What is science? Science is a systematic study of knowledge. Demonstrates. So this was about our subject. And today, in our subject science, our first chapter will be foresight machines. Our first chapter is foresight machine. Now, what is this force? How could we define force? Let me understand it by taking some examples. Students, if we want to push or pull a table, we will apply some kind of energy on the table, right? That is nothing but force. If we want to kick a ball, we will apply our energy on the ball. That is nothing but a force. Your mother will knead a floor and she will make a chapati for you by applying some kind of force. So, if you want to lift an object, that is nothing but the force. So, hence, how could we define force now? Force is nothing but any push or pull acting on an object can be considered as force. So, what is force? Any push or pull acting on an object is called force. Alright, students. So what is force? Any push or pull acting on an object is called force. That means object and force are related to one another, isn't it? So without an object, we can't apply force. So if I want to show my force, I can show by taking any of the object, right? So without there is a table, if there is no table, so even if I pull or push, there will be no force. So if I want to show the force, I need some object. So to that object, if I push or if I pull, I will apply some energy. That will be considered as force, right? right, students? So force is nothing but any push or pull acting on an object will be considered as force. Alright? Now, we have applied some kind of force on an object. Now, what will happen to that object? The object will either move away or it will come forward. Right? So, that means it will affect that object. Right? How does the force affect the object? That we will study in our next class. Alright, friends? So, till that, just go through this definition, note it by heart, and keep it ready in your notes. So, we'll go for the next topic in the next class. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.